The ceremony was attended by the Deputy Chief Justice Richard Buteda, Principal Judge Flavian Zenja, and other judges. The retired judges, who were led by Justice Asaf Luhinda, who served the judiciary from 1997 to 2022, thanked the judiciary for its appreciation for their services. However, Judge Asaf Luhinda revealed that they go through a lot of challenges serving the judiciary with limited funds during their times of service.
One obvious one was, there was no money, you people. Judiciary was so poor that it could not pay. But we persevered, we worked.
Judge Asaf Luhinda said they are currently facing significant challenges in getting the services they need in some offices. He asked the judiciary to make arrangements to ensure that they are getting the services they need.
In my mind, I was asking myself, really, if I have retired from judiciary, writing a letter to Foreign Affairs, telling them that this is a retired judge, can you please give me a diplomatic note? What does it cost?
Okim Lawrence, a former driver, said the judiciary should leave them on their health insurance they had while still in service.
It is our request that if it is possible, they still give us that service. Thank you.
Deputy Chief Justice Richard Buteda commended the judges for their commendable work. He urged other government agencies to follow the example of the judiciary.
So, it's a job which is ingratious. So every day, every time you are going home after delivering a judgment, you are being cursed and being thanked in equal measure. So no wonder when these fellows retire,
they look good. That for the case to be decided, the judge writes the judgment, but he actually doesn't do it alone. So we never achieve justice by judges working alone. We do it by a composition of justices and support staff, and we achieve one goal, delivery of justice. So we appreciate everybody.
Later, the judges and other ministers were officially honored with various gifts and served at dinner amidst joy. Report compiled by Shamshad Nalugwa for the news.